So just like loop unrolling, which had similar benefits, function call inlining has a similar downside. And that downside is the code bloat. Suppose we have the original program and it calls a function, and then it continues and calls the same function from another place and so on. Let's say that our function is 10 instructions and then a return. So now when we do our inlining, what we will do is we will effectively put the 10 instructions here and replace the call, and also take the same instructions, put them here and replace the call. So what used to be 10 instructions plus 1 for the return plus 2 for calling, altogether 13 instructions, now becomes 10 instructions here and 10 instructions here. And although we eliminated the overheads, so there are no longer function calls and returns, and possibly some small amount of argument copying and so on, still we have replicated the body of the function as many times as there are places in the code that call it. Some functions are called from hundreds of places, which means that the body of the function will now be replicated many, many times. This means that we really need to be judicious about when do we do function call inlining. We cannot inline all of the functions that we want. We want to inline functions that are small, because the fewer instructions we have here, the more we are likely to offset the additional instructions we put in here by the removal of some of the overheads. But as the function goes big, the replication results in a lot more code than the original calling and returning code did.